loving soul I know. You make me a better person, and you inspire me to live life to the fullest every day. You encourage me to reach for my dreams and to remain strong in the most difficult situations. I feel loved unconditionally by you, and that makes me feel free. I can't wait to have a family someday, and we'll be able to teach our children what our parents have taught us about life, and especially about love. You are a far better man than I could ever imagine for a husband. I'm so blessed to have you in my life. I pray that God will bless our marriage and be our rock and foundation. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you. I love you, Dan.
Brittany, we've shared so much together. We've experienced life together, from those days of being dropped off the beach by our parents to traveling around the world with our friends. You enrich my life in every way. You make me a better man. I'm so blessed to be here marrying you, my best friend, in front of all our family and friends. I look forward to all the adventures that we will share together. I know that as long as you're by my side, I can overcome anything that life throws my way. I'm so thrilled that our family can become one and that we can share our life and love with them. I can't express my excitement to begin our new lives together. I thank God for blessing our relationship and keeping his hand upon our lives and guiding us. Thank you for being all I could have ever asked for and more. I love you.
Brittany and Daniel, since it is your intention to join together as husband and wife, may you now face one another, hold your hands, and bind these promises upon your soul. I, Daniel, take you, Brittany, to be my wife, and I promise, before God and these witnesses, to be your loving and faithful husband, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, for as long as we both shall live. I, Brittany, take you, Daniel.
I, Brittany, take you, Daniel.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
And I promise.
And I promise.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
To be your loving and faithful wife.
In plenty and in want.
In plenty and in want.
In joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live. The sign and the symbol of their commitment to one another is the symbol of a ring, and this ring being in the shape of a circle, symbolizing the never-ending love of God. And so, Brittany, as you look at this ring on your finger, it's not just a commitment of your love for Daniel, but also a symbol of his dedication to you. And Daniel, as you look down at this ring on your finger, it's not just a symbol of your faithfulness to Brittany, but also a symbol of her fidelity to you. And so let's pray together. By your blessing, O God, may these rings be to Brittany and Daniel symbols of unending love and faithfulness, reminding them of the covenant that they have forged this day. And we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith.
As a sign of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Marriage takes work. There you go. Repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
As a sign of our constant faith.
Is a sign of our constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
In the name of the Father. And of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
You gotta want it.
Yeah.
There it is. All right. Will the two of you please kneel? And let us join our hearts together in prayer. Let us pray. Eternal Father, creator and preserver of all life, author of salvation and giver of all grace, look with favor upon the world that you have made and redeemed, and especially this day upon Brittany and Daniel. Give them such wisdom and devotion in their common life that each may be to the other a strength in need, a counselor in perplexity, a comfort in sorrow, and a companion in joy. Grant that their wills may be so knit together in your will, and their spirits into your spirit, that they may grow in love and peace with you and each other all the days of their life. Give them such grace, O God, that when they hurt each other, to recognize and confess their fault, and to seek each other's forgiveness as well as yours. Make their life together a sign of Christ's love to this sinful and broken world, that unity may overcome estrangement, that forgiveness will heal guilt, and joy will conquer despair. Give them such fulfillment of their mutual love that they may reach out in concern for others. Give to them, if it is your will, O God, the gift of children and the wisdom to bring them up to know you, to love you, and to serve you. And grant that all who have witnessed these vows today may find their own lives strengthened, and that all who are married may depart with their own promises renewed, enriched with your grace, all husbands and wives, parents and children, that loving and supporting one another, they may serve those in need and be a sign of your kingdom. And grant that the bonds by which all of your children, now united one to another, may they be so transformed by your Holy Spirit that your peace and justice will fill this earth through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You may stand up. You may light the unity candle. As Brittany and Daniel light the unity candle, we're reminded of the importance of the symbolism in Scripture at the dawn of creation when God said, "Let there be light," and there was light, and God saw that the light was good. We learn in the great prayer book of the Bible, the Psalms, that the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? We also learn from the words of Jesus that he says, "I am the light of the world. Those who follow me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." We're also reminded that Jesus says that you are the light of the world. A city built on a hill shall not be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a basket, but on a stand, so that it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, you now let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven. And in that great heavenly vision at the end of all time, in the beginning of the new creation, when it says, "And there will be no more night. They need no light of lamp nor sun, for the Lord their God will be their light, and they will reign forever and ever." You can come back to your spot. It's okay. Because before now God, and in the presence of this congregation, Daniel and Brittany have made their solemn vows to each other. They have confirmed these promises by the joining of their hands and by the giving and the receiving of rings. Therefore, by the power vested in me as an official of the great state of California, as well as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I now proclaim them to be husband and wife. Blessed be the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, those whom God has joined together. Let no one tear asunder, and we would love for the two of you to celebrate your new marriage with a kiss. And now, as God's own, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, forgiving one another as the Lord has forgiven you, and crown all these things with love, which binds everything together into perfect harmony. May the grace of Christ attend you. May the love of God surround you. May the Holy Spirit keep you, that you may live in faith, abide in hope, and grow in love from this moment on and forevermore. May it be so. You can turn and face the congregation. It is indeed my great privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Loyer for the first time as husband and wife.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.